It's early on a Tuesday evening in Stockton, California. Parole agents are arresting 41-year-old Jack Turner, described by agents as someone with an extensive history of sexual violence. Tonight, though, his only problem is the GPS monitoring ankle bracelet he is required to wear has run out of power. It is a parole violation, not an actual crime. But he is still tracked down, found on the streets of Stockton by agents who know his usual hangouts. Taken to a jail where less than 20 hours later, not even a full day behind bars, Jack Turner is let out.
Put your left foot out.
He may be a sexual offender, he may have a dangerous past, but Turner knows violating parole in the state of California means almost nothing to him.
How many times do you think you've gone through this parole violation procedure?
The week before that. So they know me real well here, so I'm always...
And is it always the same? Come in, spend a night, come out?
Come in, spend the night, come out.
In Stockton, California, this convicted sex offender has no real incentive to follow any rules of his parole.
So why are they laying
Which is why parole supervisor Susan Kane is trying to sound the alarm. She is speaking out against the state's wishes, saying she believes the public is not safe. She says she's speaking out for herself personally and not the Department of Corrections.
In all my years in law enforcement, and it's been over 30 years, I, for the first time, feel at a total loss that I can honestly say we do our job, we do the very best job that we can, but we can't protect the community with this. We can't protect them from these sex offenders, because they get out of jail the next day.
How did this happen? Two words: prison overcrowding. There's simply not enough room to keep people in jail. The state of California tried to solve its own prison overcrowding by passing a bill called AB 109, backed by the governor, Jerry Brown. It called for a realignment of where criminals serve time. Low-level offenders, and especially parole violators, would no longer come to state prisons. They would instead go to county jails. But in San Joaquin County, the jail is already under a court order to relieve its own overcrowding.
Well, I can see where
according
this is
to up. Under Sheriff John Piccone, the state dumped its problem on the county, and the county is now dumping criminals on the streets.
So no matter what the state or the governor says are the county's duties in terms of handling these parole violators, you just have no room.
The overcrowding situation is such that we can't afford it. We can't keep them here because of the court order, so we have to follow the court order.
In this county, it is Judge Richard Giuliani who makes those decisions about who stays behind bars and who doesn't. On the day we met him, he had released 4 inmates, 10 the day before. Amazingly, he admits, they shouldn't be on the streets.
Are you comfortable with who is being released?
I'm not comfortable releasing anybody. I think it's an unfortunate reality. And we do the best that we can by prioritizing the people that we do release.
Parole violators like Jack Turner, who have not committed a new crime, are usually the first to go. Susan Kane says parolees, especially sexual predators, know they can get away with almost anything.
I even had a parolee who was upset last week because we arrested him for being around minors when he's a child molester. He says, you can do whatever you want to me. I'm only going to be in jail one night, and when I get out, I'm doing what I want, and I'm going to make your life miserable.
So as we said, that report first aired last August. You would think the state of California would have taken notice and perhaps looked into the very real safety concerns one of their parole supervisors, Susan Kane, was trying to raise. Well, the state did the exact opposite. It is now trying to punish Susan Kane for appearing here on CNN. Drew Griffin joins me now with the latest. Drew, what's going on here?
John, the state of California is trying to penalize Kane for speaking out, specifically speaking on CNN. Shortly after our interview, Kane retired, and the state went after her, taking away $3,000 in salary from her last few months at work, saying she appeared on CNN without getting prior approval from her supervisors. even though, John, she made those comments not at work and made sure we knew it was her own personal opinion.
I mean, let's call this for what it is. This looks an awful lot like the state basically trying to silence a whistleblower.
Trying to silence her and perhaps, John, anyone else thinking about speaking out. We found Susan Cain on our own, and we wanted to know more about the sex offenders basically being allowed to roam the streets of Stockton, California. You would think the governor or the Department of Corrections would be equally concerned, but both the governor, Jerry Brown, and the Corrections Department have refused to comment about Susan Cain's case. And late last week, we learned the state has postponed her appeals hearing for several months. We're going to stay on it.
Yeah, it makes it even more important now to report on this story and stay on it. Thanks so much for that, Drew.